97.9 105.5 Kiss FM. It is Listen, It's Liz. And right now I have got on the phone Dr. Cesare from Slocum Dickson Medical Group. Good morning. How are you?
Good, Liz. How are you?
I mean, it's a very crazy time right now. We got a lot of people, you know, a little bit stressed, a little bit worried. And that's why we wanted to have you on the show today. Dr. Cesare, what's going on? And what are you guys doing over at Slocum Dickson Medical Group?
Obviously on everybody's mind is the coronavirus. And just as everybody is seeing on the TV and everything they hear, it is here. It is everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, the virus is something we haven't seen in the past. It is a very contagious virus. So people really do have to take measures not to get themselves infected. There's a lot of different things, and they keep changing every day or every few hours. But here at Slocum, we're trying to do a lot of containment.
Yeah.
So that we make the environment safe for our patients coming in, make them safe for our doctors and our providers, as well as our employees.
Right, very important. And Slocum Dickson Medical Group, located on Burstone Road in New Hartford, I mean, what are you guys actually doing to make sure that your patients and your employees are protected?
Right, so we're going to start to be pretty diligent about screening people that are coming in. We're going to basically bring ourselves down to two entrances so that people can't come through all the different doors.
Yeah.
We're going to have checkpoints that will check temperature and ask questions of the patients. We want them to come in and obviously be safe inside our building. So we're screening anybody that fails either the questions or has a high temperature greater than 100. We're going to limit the number of people coming in by only having one person accompanying each patient instead of several. We're going to decrease our operating hours, so we try to decrease the exposure and, you know, increase the containment.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to close at 6 o'clock every day, and urgent care hours, we're going to cut those down as well. Suspension on any type of meetings or committees so that we don't have people grouped together. We're not going to allow vendors or any other food or any other unnecessary personnel from coming into the building. So this will allow us to keep our building and our people and our patients safe.
Yeah, I mean, that's the biggest thing is keeping everybody safe and healthy. And, you know, doing this is all of this listed online, sdmg.com, and also on your Facebook and your Twitter?
Yes, Adrian will be sending that out.
Yes. So the good thing about you guys, if you guys have been posting all the time, keeping us up to date with what's going on and what you guys are doing to keep us safe on Facebook and on Twitter. So make sure that if you do have any questions or anything, sdmg.com is the place to go. So the real question, though, that I'm having, a lot of people are confused. What do you do if you think that you do have this virus?
It is very hard because everybody feels like they have snivels or a cough or great fever. And if you do, and it's, you know, it doesn't mean that you definitely have coronavirus. You may have another illness. But the first thing you should really do is actually call your physician. And by doing so, instead of coming in to see your doctor, you can actually get on the phone and sort of discuss, like, what are my symptoms? What am I feeling? You know, is there a reason for this? I mean, some people might have things such as like a urinary infection and causing them fever and not feeling well. You know, in those patients, the doctors will say, well, you need to come in and we'll see you.
Yeah.
But if anybody else displays signs and symptoms that it may be the coronavirus, then we're going to instruct them, without having them come in, to call the Oneida County Health Department and set up some type of testing.
Yeah, because that's the biggest thing is we want to keep it contained and we don't want them to just walk into Slocum Dickson.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. You don't want to come in and contaminate others.
Right.
But you want to be taken care of if you feel sick. So
right.
We don't want to ignore that. People still do get sick from other reasons.
Right. All of this information, sdmg.com, Facebook and Twitter, Slocum Dickson Medical Group, Dr. Cesare on the phone. And, you know, what's your best advice to people right now in this current moment?
Really, the best advice, and it's common sense, you don't want to be around a lot of people. So I don't necessarily tell you you have to self-quarantine, but if you do feel ill, you should. And you should probably limit the exposure to other places and other people. And really kind of stay indoors and not expose yourself to potential areas and people that might be infected.
Right. Yeah. Dr. Cesare, thank you so much for coming on and talking about this. You know, we have been trying to keep everybody as informed as possible as well. But hearing a story from a doctor is always a good thing. So thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. Slocum Dickson Medical Group. Find out more information at sdmg.com, Facebook and Twitter. And everybody stay safe and wash your hands.
That's right.